There was nothing about the starry sky that night to suggest that strange and mysterious things would soon be happening.
Hagrid, at last. And where did you get that motorbike?
Borrowed it, Professor Dumbledore, sir.
No problems, were there?
No, sir. House was almost destroyed, but I got him out all right.
Nestled in the bundle was a baby, Harry Potter, the boy who lived. For the next 11 years, Harry lived with his dreadful Aunt Petunia, Uncle Vernon, and Cousin Dudley, the Dursleys. Then one day, he received a letter inviting him to attend Hogwarts School of Witchcraft and Wizardry.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to something a little bit different than what you're normally used to. We're going to play Harry Potter and the Sorcerer's Stone for the PlayStation 2. I do know there is one for the PlayStation 1. That was the only one I've played. I have never played this version. And I figured it'd be fun for me to play. And while I was playing it, I might as well throw it up here on the channel and see what everybody else likes about it. We're going to check options first. I'm going to reverse those because normal usually means left goes right and right goes left. Subtitles on, music volume will trim down a bit as well as sound effects. Speech will go down to about 94. Alright. Actually, while I'm doing that, I should probably change broom. Alright. So without further ado, I guess we'll head right into it. I have played through the first one on the original PlayStation. This is the remake. And that would make this also, I believe it came out after the Chamber of Secrets. So if I do enjoy playing this game, we might go over to the Chamber of Secrets and play that one. And we'll just we'll make our way up through the little totem pole until we get all the way to the end. These are actually really fun games. I stopped playing at about the Goblet of Fire. I don't think I ever played that one.
Harry, Professor Quirrell will be one of your teachers at Hogwarts.
Potter, can't tell you how pleased I am to meet you.
What sort of magic do you teach, Professor Quirrell?
Defense against the dark arts. Not that you need it, eh, Potter? You'll be getting all your equipment, I suppose. I've got to pick up a new book on vampires myself.
Must get on, lots to buy. Come on, Harry. Three up, two across. Right.
It's really funny. In the DVD for the Sorcerer's Stone, in the extras bit, they had one of those, like, interactive tours through Diagon Alley. And they had, at the very beginning, that brick puzzle.
Just your wand left.
And they just kind of gave you a selection of bricks to select. And I could not for the life of me, but granted, I was like 11 or 12 years old when I was doing this. I could not for the life of me remember the combination that he chose. Thankfully, the DVD, if you fucked up enough times, it just went, oh, okay, well, we'll play a little short video of Hagrid doing it, and then we'll open it up. It's kind of like, all right, this guy's taking too long. He's a dumbass. Let's just open it up. We feel sorry for him.
Well, I say your father favored it. It's really the wand.
That's not John Hurt. Who is that?
Well, now, Mr. Potter, let's get started, shall we? If you'll kindly follow me.
I've heard this is actually a bit more accurate to the book than it was to the movies.
Pick it up, and let's see if it likes you.
Though these video games do tend to be a little bit more accurate to the book. Mostly because they can do stuff I guess the movie makers weren't able to do with the current level of filmmaking equipment that they had. Alright. Cool.
Ebony and unicorn hair.
I believe Harry's. I think I can choose which one, and I can choose one on the first try.
9 inches. Nice and flexible.
I believe Harry's was Holly and Phoenix, Phoenix feather. So, I wonder if I can choose the right one on the first try. Let's try.
Stand over there, on that platform, to try your wand.
Okay. I can do that. I believe this might be the wand. If the, music was any indicator.
Curious. How very curious.
Sorry, but what's curious?
I remember every wand I've ever sold, Mr. Potter. Every single wand. It so happens that the phoenix, whose tail feather is in your wand, gave another feather. Just one other. It is very curious indeed that you should be destined for this wand when its brother. Why, its brother gave you that scar. Yes. Curious indeed how these things happen. The wand chooses the wizard, remember? I think we must expect great things from you, Mr. Potter. After all,
you must not be named. Did great things.
Terrible.
Yes. Oh, yes.
But great.
This was such a good scene in the movie. They did a really good job with it.
The spell book that lies beyond. It will prove most valuable in all that lies ahead.
Yeah, that was gross. He was going robot-y.
Over here, Mr. Potter.
Okay. Well, first off, I'm gonna save. I did start a little bit just to make sure everything was gonna work. So, alright, we got the remember. And yes.
Fishing! Tripe.
Man, he's just not having any luck with these. I believe there are actually things like around on the bottom, so let's try looking around a bit. So I believe, yep, there are some beans here.
Over here, Mr. Potter.
Alright, I think I might try to do something real quick. One sec, it's going really weird. Alright, I fixed it.
Wax flavor.
I just had to change your setting. But now it's much better, as everybody can see.
Curry.
Alright, so I believe we wanted him to jump down here first.
Chocolate.
So we can try and get some of the stuff that was down here. Thank you for the ladder.
Over here, Mr. Potter.
Yes, I heard you the first time, but I am trying to explore and get all of these beans.
Peppermint!
Are there any more beans around here? Anything? No? Alright, now I'm going to do your shitty little jumping puzzle that you're making a poor... is he 10 or 11 in this? I believe he's 11.
Oh,
I think.
Yuck!
He comes of age when he's 17.
Revolting! Vomit flavor!
Oops. And I believe that was in
Booger
the last
spinach
book.
Flavor.
Which was book 7? I believe he's 11 at this point.
Booger flavor.
I think 10 was like where they start thinking about sending him to Hogwarts.
Spinach flavor.
So.
Toast.
That's right, he was 11. I remember in the movie, Hagrid goes like, you know, it's not every day a young man turns 11, now is he? So yeah, he's 11 right now.
Oh, bravo. Yes, indeed. Oh, very good. Well done, Mr. Potter. Once you learn some more powerful magic, you'll be able to cast more powerful Flipendo knockback jinxes.
Mm-hmm. Flipendo. And I will make Flipendo square. Like it was in the PlayStation game,
if
so I don't get confused.
Follow me.
This way, right? Yeah. Certain objects, such as glass jars, can be smashed using the Flipendo spell to release bonuses or reveal switches. Aha. Fuck you.
Coconut.
Yeah, fuck all these jars.
Sardine. Spinach flavor.
And I believe this is the one of those games where you can, yeah. I think the first time I noticed that they did that was in the third game. Because I would use that all the time and like get all these different stuff, because they had a lot of random shit in the third game that you could get. Third game was my favorite out of all the ones I played, but I did only play the first three, so I'm sure the other ones got a lot better. I just liked how in the third one you can do whatever you wanted. And I believe, like, towards the end of the year, you could just do whatever the fuck you wanted, and it's just, like, free mode at that point. So I ended up, like, I wonder what's down here. I ended up getting all of the secrets just because I had nothing else to do at that point. I remember you could change the hippogriff that you got, so I would always choose, like, a different color hippogriff whenever I wanted. Felix Summerby.
Felix Summerby.
Oh, sorry.
1447 to 1508. Inventor of cheering charms.
Cool. That is the guy who does the audiobooks that I like. I know there's like two that do audiobooks for Harry Potter. I only ever read the first guy. I didn't use the second one. I'm sure it's like his last name's Dale. I think it's Jim Dale. But I didn't want to assume, because I was going to probably get it wrong. But he was the one that I listened to. I didn't listen to the other guy, because I've heard they have two distinct, not methods, just kind of mannerisms when they read the books.
These three large shields on the far wall can be flipped using your Flipendo knockback jinx. Flip them in the correct order.
Okay. If that's what you want me to do. To target, you can press the block, move or target nearby. You can cycle through them by quickly pressing the target button again. Alrighty. This looks like I'm going to need to hit the sun, then the moon, then the sun. I'm going to say that's probably a star, though. It's alright. Oh. I gotta hold it. And that one. And that one. There you go. I'm super smart. I do not remember
Before
having to do all of this in the movie or in the book.
To collect the folio brutai.
Okay. Book of Beasts. This book shows the name and appearance of each beast you may encounter in your adventures. The folio brutai will teach you their strengths and weaknesses. An imp. Imp is sometimes confused with a pixie. They're of a similar height and both have a slapstick sense of humor. Imps are vicious little creatures. You will need to use Flipendo to knock them back before picking them up and throwing them in a hole, like a gnome, or into an open cage. Cool. Why would I need to know that, Ollivander? What? Are you just leaving me? You bastard. This was his plan. He's working for Voldemort already. He's locked me in a room with imps.
Can be a nuisance. Try knocking them over with Flipendo. Then pick them up and lock them in the cages.